Hey guys, so I was sitting on my couch trying to make a TeamForge 2 video, but my Steam machine was so laggy. Even though I had all the settings turned down, the resolution turned down, like, no shit, you know, all the advanced settings on minimum. And it was still getting extremely laggy. My ping was fine, so I don't think it's my connection. But I started to become concerned that something had come loose in the Steam machine during shipment, and that's why I'm having all these lag issues and no one else seems to be. So I figured, why not take the thing apart, try to clean it up, record the whole thing so you guys can watch.
This is going to be a learning experience for all of us. So here's the Steam machine. Looks like I have to take off this screw in the back. This whole time I'll try to position it so everyone can see. And let's see if this top comes off.
Tell me your secrets.
Oh. Alright, this slides forward. And then you can take this off. Carefully. There we go. This is some kind of spacer for the video card. Here you can get a good look on the insides. Looks like we have our video card, our SATA drive, probably a CPU cooling fan, and then our power supply over here. Looks like everything's just held in with Phillips head screws, so that should make things very easy. I definitely want to make sure that all the power and connections are seated well. So let's see what we can do about that. Go ahead and take off the hard drive cover first. Screw number one, screw number two, and off it goes. Oh, you stay there. So as a lot of people have pointed out, there's definitely space for another drive in here. Pretty cool. You can see the motherboard down there. That is a terabyte hard drive right there. Let's see what we can do about getting this video card out. Looks like the screw on the back is holding it in. There. Oh! Power supply is on top. Here is my pre-GeForce. Oh, wow. That thing's a powerhouse. Oh! So satisfying. That fits in there really tight. They really did a good job when they were putting this together, it looks like. I love this kind of stuff. I love building computers and everything. You know what? Let's go ahead and take this off first. At least a lot of these screws seem to be the same size and same thread. A lot of uniformity, which I appreciate a lot. Oh, USB 3.0 header. Power cables, power cables. What is that? Oh, another screw. Ooh, there we go. Now we can see that itty-bitty motherboard. And those itty-bitty sticks are right. It is a riser card. That's so cool. I don't know why. Here's where we stand so far. We've got our itty-bitty motherboard, itty-bitty riser card, so the GPU can go in sideways. Two sticks of RAM. Power supply looks modular back in here, which is very cool. And let's keep taking things apart. I love the cable management in here so far. It's pretty masterful for someone who just kind of crams their cables and their computers off to the side. There's like a nice little channel here for these two cables, and I don't know, it's just really well done. I love it. Let's see if we can get this cover out. What the hell? N6. Ooh, neat. Silverstone. Sounds lovely. And there comes that cover. Ooh, so now you can see a lot more of the cable management, how we have these channels run through. This is pretty cool. It'd be really fun to see what some of the other Steam boxes look like on the inside too. So far I haven't really seen any reason that I would have had any stuttering issues in my games. Maybe it's just still SteamOS is buggy, but everything seems to be well connected. Let's pop out this RAM and see if that can help at all. Itty bitty RAM. That's interesting. They actually included a wire for a second hard drive. That's really forward-thinking on Valve's behalf. I don't really want to mess with the power supply, but it is definitely power supply-y. Oh, that's interesting. This fan seems really loose. Maybe that got knocked off. Wow, just a little clip-in doodad. Never seen something like that. Maybe this isn't secure enough, and that's why it's stuttering. Maybe it's just an overheating issue. One last screw on the motherboard. It looks like some of the other screws I already took out were multi-purpose. There's a little motherboard. There's all these tiny little screws in here, and I don't feel like taking those out. So there's the power supply. There you have it. Steam machine disassembled. Now let's hope that I can put it back together again.
And I did. If you like this video, be sure to give these links a click over here to check out some of my other videos. Also, feel free to leave a comment down below if you'd like to see any specific videos from me. I promise I'm going to try to get that Team Fortress 2 video out pretty soon, as well as Bastion, Amnesia, and Super Meat Boy, because I need to do a platform, apparently. So, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.